Hey everybody, I'm back with another update on my hydroplane build.
And if you'll recall, last time we were working on the transom, I've got it pretty much done. And I'm happy with how it turned out. Cleaned up pretty well. And I wanted to go over the process for doing that final cleanup. So if you'll recall, we had this mahogany piece that was rough cut to match the walnut frame. The walnut frame was pretty smooth, pretty symmetrical, and what I did was I trimmed the mahogany piece to it with a flush cut trim bit on my router. I don't use this router that much just because it's kind of big, it's kind of bulky, it's very nice, but oftentimes I'll use this old little router. But this was a case where this one, it chewed through it, did a really fine job of it. So I used this router, and I trimmed the mahogany frame, the mahogany main transom piece to the walnut frame. And then, in the corners, there's some round off because you can't get in there with the router bit. And so I used a chisel and some of these little flush cut saws. So these are great. Always want to have a chisel set, nice sharp chisel. You can just kind of chip off and chew through little bits of material. And having this kind of tiny little, tiny little dovetail type saw is great. The problem with this is it has the this backing on it, and so you can't get up exactly tight on something. It always angles it out a little bit. So I'll use this Japanese pull saw, which you can get flush up on something, trim it off, and it's got rough cut. It's not focusing quite right, but it's got rough cut teeth, and it's got a little bit coarser teeth. So take your pick. You can trim something up nice and tight. You can bend it flat, trim something, and that's great for trimming material flush. And then I used Japanese rasp. It's great for hogging out material. If you have a lot you have to remove, I actually didn't use it that much on the transom, but I did just want to. I did occasionally use it to just remove some material real quick. And I use this little block plane in a lot of places, just along the edges to get everything nice and flush, and also on these faces here. And if you'll remember, this mahogany, this is actually two pieces. You can't even really see where they're glued together. I cleaned that up with a block plane. A lot of that was done with a block plane, but I also used cabinet scrapers, and cabinet scrapers are really they worked really well for this. This is a pretty thin, flexible one that's I used a little bit, but mostly I actually used this pretty stout cabinet scraper, and it's really good for getting up in these corners here. So there was some squeeze out along along the frame and the mahogany transom piece, and just kind of got in there and scraped away. And when you have cabinet scrapers, you want to make sure that you're able to sharpen them properly. You basically have a little burr that you put on the edges, and what you do is you just sharpen them up. I don't have my sharpening stones out right now, but you get everything nice and flat, and then run this hardened steel rod along it. It's hard. I don't have enough hands, but basically put a burr on it with that, and then I put a burr like on pretty much all the edges, so I could get in and I could scrape along this surface, I could scrape along this surface, and just get all the glue out, get everything nice and smooth. And obviously you also have just a flexible sanding block, and just a regular sanding block, which I used in some spots. But the finish that's left by a block plane and the cabinet scrapers, super smooth. Don't need to sand it. So, and if you sand it, usually you're actually making it a little bit rougher. So that was the process that I used. Those are the tools that I mostly use for finishing up this this transom. I'm going to go ahead and I have some of these walnut offcuts that I'm going to use to fill in some of these gaps here. Really not happy with those, but you know, it's still structurally sound. It's just a little bit uglier than I'd like it to be. And well, that's life. Gotta fill those in. And I'll also, one other thing, anytime you're cutting stuff, you just want to make sure that you save all of, or at least some of, the dust. And so I have some mahogany dust, I got some walnut dust, and I can mix that in with the glue, fill in those gaps, it'll blend right in, it'll look great, hopefully. So anyways, that's all I got. I'm going to be putting together the all the frame members. I got to figure out how to get them all set up, held together, and run the stringers between them. That's what I'm going to be doing this weekend. I got a nice long weekend to work on it. And so hopefully there will be some more updates coming soon. All right, bye.